Now here, as the positive charge is here, and on this bigger sphere, negative charge is here, positive charge here, and when it is conducting, means we have connect a conducting wire and fixed it with ground, then what will happen now? In that situation, children, that your answer will be like, then the from the ground, electrons will start moving. And these electrons are moved to the conducting wire and raised to the post this sphere. The positive charge will get neutralized. Means how many electrons as the amount of depending upon the how much positive charge is there. So the same number of electrons is being attracted by the positive charge on the metal sphere. And then you can say that they combine together for one positive combined with one negative like. So that the result will be zero. Means this one positive charge will disappear, second positive charge, third positive charge, maybe the fourth positive charge is there. So they disappear once it is connected with the earthing wire. So that your explanation, children, that if you say that the positive charge will go to the ground, that positive charge cannot go to the ground, but negative charge will come from the ground and they will get neutralized with the positive charge and make the positive charge disappear. Okay, so you can't say that the positive charge will pass through. If you mention that the positive charge means the proton or the positive charge, this positive charge are going in this way. So that is the wrong explanation. Physics cannot explain that the positive charge will flow in this way. So just be careful here while finding the answer of this question, children, when you write your answer in exam. And one more thing, children, this happens here. Now positive get neutralized. This was the part of the induction, children. I already explained. If you are not struggling in this part, children, I have recorded some lesson and that you can find this recorded lesson on the YouTube channel also, children. So now, still the earthing wire is there. Let me put here on the earth. Positive charge disappear. Remove this wire now. Remove this wire. I think in the second, next part, what they said here, state and explain what happened to the charge on the smaller sphere, this part. What happens to the positive charge disappeared. Now only the negative charge remains on the small sphere. But after that, and in the C part, explain in terms of their structure, why the metal wire is an, okay, that they have not asked here. And in the next part, you know, children, if I remove the conducting wire, or that is the earthing wire, and if I remove the positive charge metal sphere, then what will happen? That the negative charge will uniformly distributed on the surface of this conductor, smaller sphere. This will happen only when this is removed, taken away, and earthing wire is not there. Fine, that's the final step. So explain in terms of their structure, why the metal wire is an electrical conductor. Why metal is a conductor? You know, due to the presence of free electrons. Why the plastic stand is an insulator? Due to the not presence of the free electrons. Electrons are there, but not the free electrons are there. One more question, children, that the question number 7. And in question number 7, what is meant by an electric field? The same definition, children. You may not remember that definition, the force experienced by a charged particle when it is placed in electric field. Then the second part shows a metal positive sphere, and then you need to draw the pattern of electric field in the space around this sphere. In the space around the sphere, how will you draw? Who will annotate? Who will annotate here? Enable annotation for others. Anyone, please. Anushka Bedi, okay, please you do. Karthik Anushka, okay.
Yeah, sir.
Okay, one thing, children, that you should remember here in this question, that even you are using that your stylus pen, that it will be difficult to draw the lines. But that the one thing which you should remember, that positive charge, and then you know that the lines will be outward. So let me take few lines here. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So when I put the arrow sign, that the arrow sign should be at the same position here. If the single sign is there, right, that will show the a uniform electric field. Means if you draw a diagram like this, one more diagram will then 3 and 4 lines suppose here. One arrow here, second you are putting like this, third you are some putting here. So if you're drawing in this way, then up to a certain extent, we can say that the diagram is correct, but still it's not a fully correct diagram. You are showing the outward arrows, but due to the single postage charge, at the same distance, you know that at the same distance, the field will be same. E will be same here, as E is inversely proportional to the R square. So at this point, suppose this is A point, this is B point, this is C point, at D point, that the electric field will be same. But if I take another point at the P point, at the Q point, at the R point, and at the PQ or S point, this will be different. So it's not that sometimes I can see that this length of this arrow and this length of this arrow. So please remember, okay, it's not randomly just you draw the line with the mouse. You have to be careful. I appreciate that you can annotate here, children. Yes, Anirudh?
Oh, no, sir, nothing. Okay. I was saying that I'm all done.
Okay. Now, the next is B part. It shows a metal sphere on an insulating stand. A student has available 2 rods. Yeah, this is also very, very important question. You read by yourself, children, and then I will ask this question to Atharva and Ankit. I have not heard any things from you. Harshan, you also please try.
So in this question, we have to choose only one rod, right?
Yes. Yeah.
From either of these.
Yeah. Okay. Read carefully. Take some time, children. Before writing your answer, children, first read the statement carefully once, twice, or thrice.
Can I answer?
Okay, Ashmit. Yeah, please explain.
Okay, because she uses a positive rods, mm-hmm. negative charges will be attracted towards it, and the positive charges will be behind, repelled. So then she can place a wire or earth the sphere with her fingers. By that, electrons from the earth comes and cancels out the positive charges. That then she removes the earthing wire or something, and removes the rod and the sphere is negatively charged.
So let me explain this question to all of you children. Our student has available 2 rods. One is positive and other one is negative. So let me draw here. One rod is positively charged and other one is negatively charged. So the question is, using one of these rods, she gives the sphere a overall negative charge. Negative charge appear on the sphere by induction. So which rod she will prefer and describe the procedure. So in a short cut, children, that you should remember, if you need to produce the negative charge, definitely opposite charge rod should bring closer to that. If you have to produce negative charge, so it means you need to bring positive charge. So your answer will be positive rod she should bring. And if the question is that you need to, make this sphere positively charged, positive charge. So then negative charge rod should be closer to it. And then the process, as the Ashmit explained, that you need to then touch the other end of the rod with the what? Earthing wire should be there, then the earthing wire, that what happens, that the on one side that the charges will disappear, then finally remove the earthing wire, then finally remove the that the rod, and finally you will get negative and positive charge accordingly. As per this statement, children, you have to bring positive plus rod. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay, thank you. So solenoid is still, we are not talking about this related to the chapter number 8, magnetism. And after that, that's now Sudan.